was on self-destruct. I had to change my life, because if I didn't, I'd have ended up dead, a drug addict, or just in jail, doing like big jail. I'll never forget his words, and these were his exact words. He went, put it in the palm of my hand, and he went, don't let this fuck your life up, mother. And then my life just went on a massive downward spiral for about, when was that? It was about 2-3 years, yeah. But I just remember taking it, and then I was up then, I was addicted to that lifestyle. Somebody said to me, you're taking drugs. You'd be like, yeah, I'm fucking taking drugs. Why, what the fuck's it got to do with you? The police had raided the apartment where I had been out, off my head, just on a mission, don't know where I went. The police had raided the apartment, and June come up to me, she said, Martin, they've all been arrested for drugs. They're looking for you. I was sleeping on the streets in the night, wherever I could get my head down. I had no money, they took me money. Seen some wild fights in them youth offenders, like over nothing. It's a 23-hour bang up. And then obviously fights, people getting done in cells, people getting done in showers. Fighting everywhere. It was wild, honestly. It was wild. Cut my tag off, my 21st birthday. So then I was on run then. I took this thing called GHB, which, again, just massively fucked my life up. All doormen went out. It was only me and this other lad, and then like loads of doormen. Just another big mad brawl. Please come. CS gassed us both through his van. Next minute, knock on door, coppers there, nicked me. So he just told them where I was. So handcuffed me, frog marched me through town. The years have gone. Cocaine come into play then. So obviously, again, started on that. Just ended up a big mass brawl. Just everybody. Fucking hell, mate, watch what you're doing here. She went, fuck off, stuck head on me. Yeah, just for nothing. Coked up. That was our first date. I got choked out. So she must have been thinking, God, he's right what they're saying. That was in Walton then, 2005. That was completely different. Another level, like, you know what I mean? Just the violence, like, there was a lot of slashings in there over the tiniest thing, like, you know what I mean? And just the things that you see and the people you're around. Been up all night, smoking a joint at the time as well. Got a phone call off Steve Birch. Martin, what's up, Steve? All right, he went, listen, just finished training there. Johnny wants to know, do you want to win ABAs? The weigh-in's Friday. So I was like, yeah, bang, just put the joint down straight away. Back at gym next day. Going out there drinking, it was a way of life. Going to jail, it's just a way of life. And that's what it was. So for me, it was normal. But for Gemma, it wasn't. So inside me just popped where I just knew I was done with that life. I just knew it. I couldn't put my finger on it, but I just knew I was done with it. But then when I won it, I wouldn't even ask them about the 25 grand, do you know what I mean? I was just buzzing for winning. And then someone reminded me, you won 25 grand. I'm like, fucking get it buzzing. The amount of money that I've been ripped off with, really, over years. So in the fights that I missed and I could have had, he coming out, I had orc eyes on him, was like, there he is, fucking this is it. But he come in and he didn't even know he was fighting. I just think he thought it was just going to be an easy fight. Golovkin was just on an all different level. He hit me once with three left uppercuts inside, like, you know what I mean? Just like, bam, bam, bam. Knew I'd beat him, just couldn't do what we needed to do for beating, you know what I mean? We knew we needed all sense of ring, pushing back. It's a fucking hard game. It's an hard sport. I don't really want to speak about it, so I won't speak about it, actually, because it'd get me upset. But I'll never forget it, yeah.